Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about touch-tone dial telephone system. In that, we also discussed the design considerations such as choice of code board, choice of frequency, band separation, signaling power, and signaling duration. Along with that, we also discussed about the mechanical aspects such as size of the button, size of the keypad, and the location of the switches, and also the force required to push the button. Right? Now, in this class, we will discuss another switching system, that is crossbar switching system. So, this is another electromechanical switching system. Okay? Now, these are the different crossbars invented in the years and corresponding laboratories. Now, I am going to explain a simple 3x3 switching matrix. So, this is a picture of a crossbar exchange. Now, we will see the principles of crossbar switching system. So, the basic idea is to provide n cross m sets of contacts with only n plus m activators to select one of the n cross m set of contacts. Okay. The objective is to provide a matrix which contains n cross m sets of contacts with only n plus m activators or less. Whether it is a blocking or non-blocking, we can go for reduced number of those activators. And with help of that, we have to select one of n cross m set of contacts. So, this is the basic idea behind the switching, crossbar switching system or an exchange. Now, I am going to show a simple example of 3x3 crossbar switching system. So now, in this, I will show you what are the components present in this crossbar switching system. You can see some wires, horizontal and vertical wires. So these are called as horizontal wires, these are called as vertical wires. These wires are required to establish electrical path between the calling and call subscriber. That is the first one. And second one is, contact points. Second one is contact points. It contains some contact points on both vertical and horizontal wires. This pair is called as a cross point switch. Okay. Now, the third one is, it contains horizontal as well as vertical bars. We call them as horizontal and vertical bars. Okay. To rotate these horizontal and vertical bars, we use electromagnets. So these are the components present inside a crossbar switching system. Now we will see the operation, how to establish a connection between a calling and call subscriber. Here the technical word is latch up. If a contact point is, if a cross point is activated, then we can call it as a latch-up condition. Okay. Now we'll see the explanation of how to establish this latch-up. For example, I want to make a call between ANC. My objective is to establish a connection between ANC. So for that, you have to apply some procedure. That is, first energize horizontal A. Then you have to energize vertical C. Therefore, here this particular pair of cross points get latched up. Clear? How this is happening? Initially, before applying the magnetization, this is the orientation of these cross points. Okay. So whenever we energize the corresponding bars, either it may be a horizontal or vertical, what happens? This particular bar contact point will rotates like this. Similarly, whenever energize the vertical bar, it is going to rotate like this. Now, here these two contacts face each other to create an electrical connection. This connection is called as a latch up connection. Latch up. Clear? So, by properly energizing the horizontal and vertical bars, we are going to bring the faces of these contact points to one side such that it is going to create some electrical path between A and C. This condition is called as a latch up. So now here are words, I am going to use the word latch up whenever I want to establish a connection between the calling and call subscriber. Okay. Here you can follow two schemes are there. Scheme one is energize horizontal first, energize horizontal, energize vertical. This one you can use this method, or energize vertical and energize horizontal. So you can use either one of the scheme to obtain latch up. Generally we use the first method, energizing the horizontal bars, then energizing the vertical bars. Okay. Now I am going to explain a 6x6 cross bus system to establish two different connections. So what are the challenges you are going to face while you are establishing two connections here? So here my objective is to establish a connection between A to C. This is one connection. Another one is between B and E. Okay. My objective is, with the help of this switching system, I should be able to establish a connection between A to C. And example, we observe that we have to energize the horizontal first, then we have to energize vertical next. Now, first I am going to establish AC connection. So for that, I have to energize the horizontal first, then I have to energize vertical next. Therefore, here the latch up takes place. Okay. Latch up takes place between A and C subscriber. Now, secondly, I want to establish a connection between B and E. For that, you have to energize B first. If you observe clearly, here already C is energized. Therefore, here BC also gets latched up. That means B is bridged to the circuit of A and C. B is brought into the circuit of A and C, which is not desired. Okay, so how to overcome this problem? Our objective is to establish connection between B and E, but unexpectedly we are getting B into the AC circuit. So to overcome this problem, we have to define some conditions. What is the condition for proper latch up? First, enable horizontal, then enable vertical. If this order is following, then only the latch up takes place. If not, means the latch up will not take place. Clear? Now apply the same thing here once again. First, to establish AC latch up, energize horizontal A and energize vertical C. Therefore, the sequence is followed. Therefore, latch up takes place at AC. Now take B now, energize horizontal B. Here if you observe clearly, vertical is first energized and horizontal is second energized. Therefore, it is varied in the sequence. Therefore, what happens? BC will not get latched up. Therefore, BC will not get latched up. Now, B is energized. Now, energize vertical E. Then what happens? Since the order is followed, energize horizontal and energize vertical. Therefore, latch up takes place. Now, what happened to AE? Here also the condition satisfied. Horizontal A is first energized and vertical E is second energized. The sequence is correct now. Therefore, AE also get latched up. That means, unintentionally, this A is brought into circuit of B and D also. Therefore, this process also not good. Now, to overcome all these problems, we have to follow some sequence. What is the sequence? Energize horizontal bar, then energize vertical bar. Finally, we have to do de-energize horizontal bar. If you follow the sequence, then automatically unnecessary latchups may not take place. Apply the same thing here. A is energized, C is energized, then de-energize A. Therefore, while establishing BE latchup, A is not energized. Therefore, A will not brought into circuit of B. So, in these structures, you have to follow this scheme to establish the latchup connection. This is scheme 1. You can also follow scheme 2. What is scheme 2? Scheme 2 is energize vertical, then energize horizontal, and finally you have to de-energize vertical. You can follow any one of the scheme for proper latch up. Okay. So this is in this structure. What are drawbacks we are observing here? So here you can see a contact switch or cross point switch AB and a cross point switch BA. So this cross point switch AB will activated if A is initiating a call. This cross point BA is activated if B is initiating a call to A. That means in this case, based on the subscriber who is initiating the call, that particular cross point is latched up. So because of this reason, for this circuit, we are having so many number of cross point switches. In generally, for n subscribers, it requires n square cross points if I am using this type of topology. This comes under a non-blocking network. This comes under a non-blocking network. But if you observe clearly, the number of cross points which are more in this system. Now, crosswalk switching configurations. So, as an engineer, our objective is to utilize the cross points effectively. Okay, unnecessary should not waste the cross points because the cost increases. As the number of cross points increases, the cost of system increases. And also, you have to look into the factor of utilization factor. Right? If utilization factor is more, means your design is good. If it is less, means the design is bad. Now, we'll see what is the configurations for a non-blocking crosswalk systems. I am taking an example of 4. If 4 subscribers are there, how many cross switching points or cross points are required? N square, right? For n subscribers, it requires n square in case of non-blocking configuration. What is in LDR? For 16. What is switching capacity? We already know that one active call means 2 subscribers. Right? So for 4 subscribers, what is the number of active calls? 2. General formula is n by 2. N by 2 is the switching capacity for any network. So for this it is 2. What is the formula of inflation factor? What is the formula? We already discussed, right? Switching capacity by number of links there. Here it is number of switching elements or cross point switches. What is the answer? This is nothing but switching capacity is 2 by, it is how much? 16. What is the value? This is 0.125. See, nothing but cost of 1 switch means cost is equal to 1. So if it is 16 means the total cost is 16. If you take it as unit value, 16 units cost. What is CCI? CCI means cost capacity index. The formula of CCI is switching capacity by number of cost per subscribers. Cost per subscribers. That is equal to how much? Switching capacity is 2 by CA 16 by N is how much? N is equal to 4. That is equal to how much? 8 by 16. That is equal to 0.5. This is the formula of cost capacity index. More the cost capacity index, the result is more efficient. Now our objective is to improve the utilization factors. So there are 3 methods are proposed to improve the utilization factors, or how to decrease the number of switching elements. Okay, the first one is using a diagonal cross points matrix. So in this case, what I am trying to do is, we are going to reduce the number of cross points. In the previous case, we are using 2 switches, AB as well as BA. We establish the connection between A to B. So based upon the subscriber who is originating the call, it is going to use the appropriate switch. If A is initiating the call, it is going to use AB switch. If B is initiating call, it is going to use BA switch. Now in case of diagonal cross point matrix, we are going to use only 1 switch instead of 2. So whoever may be initiating the call, it is going to use only 1 cross point switch to establish a connection between A to the B. In this way, we can able to reduce the number of cross point switches. See here. So this is the previous case. So what I am trying to do here, I am going to eliminate the remaining switching cross point switches. Therefore, this is the modified crossbar switching system. Okay, so our switching matrix. So in this also, we can eliminate some cross points. So A to A cross point is not required. B to B cross point is not required. So therefore, I can also eliminate the diagonal cross points. Now verify how many are there. How many cross points are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, for 5 subscribers, it requires only 15 cross point switches. In the previous case, for 5 subscribers, it requires 25 switching points. Clear? So now, what is the formula for n subscribers? This formula is n into n minus 1 by 2. If I am going to connect the subscribers in this diagonal fashion, then the number of cross point switches required is n into n minus 1 by 2. If you want to check means, substitute the value 5 in this case, because how many are there here? Sorry, 6. 6 subscribers, right? So 6 into 6 minus 1 by 2, nothing but how much? It is 15. Right? Clear? Okay. So in this way, we can able to reduce the number of cross point switches with the help of diagonal switching matrix connection. if you observe clearly, this same formula we seen somewhere else, right? In case of point to point connection, that for a fully connected network, the total number of links required is the same formula, right? N into n minus 1 by 2. Therefore, this particular diagonal connection switching matrix is an example for a fully connected network. Therefore, it comes under a non-blocking network. Okay. So this is the first way to improve the utilization factor by reducing the number of cross point switches. And the second one is by reducing bars. Okay, by reducing the number of bars, you can able to improve the utilization factor. See here, in the previous case, if I am having 6 subscribers, means I am going to use 6 horizontal bars as well as 6 vertical bars, right? But in case of the second method, we are going to use a single bar for 2 subscribers. We are going to use a single bar for 2 subscribers. So for six subscribers, I can go to use only 3 bars connecting 2 subscribers for a given pay. By rotating this bar clockwise and anti-clockwise, you can able to establish connection for either A or B. So here A comma B are connected, B C or C D E F. Okay. In this way, we can able to reduce the hard way. This is second method. And third method is keeping the inlet same, but by reducing the vertical bars, we can able to improve the efficiency. So this is a method I am going to show here. This comes under the blocking network. This comes under the blocking network. Here for 7 subscribers, I am going to use only 3 vertical bars. I am going to use only 3 vertical bars. But here, how to establish a connection? My objective is to establish a connection between A to the B. In this case, we have to follow some procedure. What is the procedure I have to follow here? Energize horizontal first, then choose any one of this vertical bar. Okay, that for time being, I am choosing the vertical bar P. Okay, since horizontal first energized, then vertical, therefore a latch up takes place at AP. So this is a latch up at AP. Now, since here still A is not connected to B, now energize B. Now we have to choose another vertical bar which is having electrical path between P. So which one is that is having? So this is not R, this is a P prime, this is R prime. Okay, now for P to P dash, I can see one electrical path. Therefore, I am going to energize P dash next. Therefore, since it is following the order, a latch up occurs at V P dash. Okay, since P and P dash are having electrical path, automatically there is a connection between A to B. Therefore, we establish a connection between A to B. It is going to use 2 horizontal bars as well as 2 vertical bars. Okay. Here, to overcome the above problem, we are going to use 2 schemes. One is energize horizontal first, A, then energize both horizontal A and B, then energize both vertical P and P dash, then de-energize A and B. So you have to follow this sequence to establish a connection between A to B. Okay, in the next class we will see the same logging network with the transfer lines.